This is a quick overview of the tools available when you're designing your own charts. So let's start at the bottom left. This is the paint tool. If you select it, you get some extra options. The first one is to change the stitch symbol. So I'm going to change this to a pearl symbol. Second one is the background color of the stitch. Most of the time you would use white, but you can change it to anything you like. So let's change this to yellow. And the last one is the color of the stitch symbol itself. So when you're ready, just tap anywhere on the canvas to start drawing. The second tool is the eraser. Just tap anywhere on your canvas to erase the stitches. Next is the selection tool. You have two options. The first one is the cell selection tool, and the second one is the object selection tool. Let's start with the cell selection tool. Tap and hold on your canvas and just drag around to create a selection box. Here you get some extra options. The first one is to copy the stitches. Second one is to paste the stitches. So if you move your selection box around and select paste, it would look like this. Here you have the option to cut the stitches. This is just to clear the selection box. You can also flip the stitches horizontally and vertically. This is the crop tool. This will crop your chart to the current selection box, like this. This tool is to add your selection to the designs library. You find the designs library at the top left under more options here. And these are designs you want to reuse in other charts you're designing. There are some presets here, like characters, stuff like that, and some repeating borders. So if you select a design, you get a new selection box, which you can place anywhere, and then select paste to paste the design into your chart. The last option at the bottom is to fill the selection box with the current stitch. So it looks like this. The second selection tool is the object selection tool. If you select an object, you get some extra options again. This is to duplicate the object like this. You can also scale it using a slider, but you can also use the handles, for instance, to rotate it. This is to send an object to the background. So if I select this, it will appear behind the other graphic. This is to change the color, obviously. And with this tool, you can change the thickness of the line like this. If you select the text box, you get some other options, for instance, the font size. You can also use the more options here and then show a text bracket above the text, for instance, to repeat this section. The next tool is to place objects on top of your chart. You have some options here. The first one is to add an image. This is an info dot. Those are these ones. They can contain text or an image or also a URL to a YouTube video, for instance. Then you have the option to place a text box, for instance, to mark a section as a repeating section. And this is to place a marker and some shapes you can place on top of your chart. The last tool is to activate the working mode. In the working mode, your chart is locked, so you can't make any changes to it. And you can easily keep track of the current row and also of the current stitch.